Cześć! In today's episode, I will be talking you through the differences between the bags of specialty coffee beans and the bags of commodity coffee beans. What I really want you to know at the very beginning of this video is that I have no sponsors whatsoever. Nobody paid me. I didn't choose any particular roastery or coffee producer that I wanted to recommend. This video will be only about the informations that are very universal when it comes to informations provided by specialty coffee producers and specialty coffee roasteries. This will be a guideline for you to answer a question: what information am I actually looking for? Let's say that for some reason you happen to have a bag of coffee beans in your hands. What are the informations that you are looking for? So they could be an indicator for you to tell whether inside the bag there are some specialty coffee beans or not. Here they are. Information number one and two, country of origin. There is around 80 countries producing the coffee. Most of the coffee production happens in Brazil, but there is also Colombia and Guatemala, Ethiopia, Kenya, Vietnam and Indonesia, and so on and so on. The list is there. Around all of those countries, there is 124 known species of coffee. Species, so types of coffee plants. Most common ones are Arabica and Robusta. But there is also a Liberica or Stenophylla, and I just said that to show off. Each of the species has also its varietals. Only Arabica has around 80 known varieties. Why am I saying it? Each of the country, each of the species, each of the variety has their own characteristics when it comes to the flavor and aroma of the coffee. It can be an indicator of whatever you want to choose, the coffee that tastes more like a chocolate or the coffee that tastes more like a mandarin. Roasteries that are proud of their products will definitely tell you where the coffee is from. Moreover, they might potentially also write the particular region that a coffee is from, because the country itself is the one thing. But quite often, specific regions create microclimates, and that might have a huge impact of how the coffee tastes as well. We're gonna talk about how the country, how the species, how the variety impacts the flavor of the coffee later on in the episodes. For now, all you need to know is more data about where your coffee comes from and what variety that is, the better. Information number two. Well, technically three. Processing. Processing applies to the way of how they take a little bean out of the coffee cherry. Coffee grows on the trees. Going back to how coffee grows on the trees. The trees give fruits, and inside the fruits there are coffee beans. Technically, it's not even a bean, it's actually a drupe. So like peaches. The way how the coffee was processed has a massive impact on how the coffee tastes later on. This step is usually taken in the plantation, on the processing station, still in the country of origin. The length of the process might vary, the amount of sun coffee gets, the amount of water coffee gets, the fermentation might be involved. There's so much. We don't need to know that now. The most common methods are washed/wet, natural/dry, and then we have honey or carbonic maceration or anaerobic or... Stop showing off! We're not gonna go deep into science of which particular method gives you what particular flavors. All you need to know for now is that by washing the coffee, we receive slightly more acidic coffee than by coffee that was done in the natural way. The naturals give coffees that are potentially a little bit sweeter, going more into red wine flavors, chocolate, cocoa, but also there is an exception of all the rules. So let's move on. Information number three, or technically four, altitude. Some of the roasteries like to provide their consumers with the information of how high the coffee was growing. The general rule is that the higher the coffee grows, the more needy it is, the more sophisticated it is, the more delicate. Usually, the higher you go, conditions are getting more and more difficult. Looking after the coffee growing in a very demanding environment is not easy, but if it's done properly, it rewards in the flavor of the coffee. If you are someone who's looking for very special flavors, you might reach out for bags that were growing in the higher altitude. If you're looking for a coffee more classic and it was also easier for farmers to provide you with, go for a lower altitude. Information number What number? Five. Roasting profile. Just because you have coffee coming from this particular country, this particular variety, it was growing in this particular altitude, and it was processed in this particular way, it doesn't necessarily mean that at all. There is a lot of different profiles of how the roaster can deal with the coffee when it comes to roasting it. Not all the coffees have to be roasted the same way. So you will see the label saying filter coffee or espresso coffee or dark roast or light roast. These are the information being also an indicator of what particular coffee you have in front of you might be used for what method. Maybe you have a moka pot at home and you are looking for a coffee that will taste good made with this particular equipment. Only by checking the roast profile, you will be able soon, if you watch next episode, to tell which coffee will go better with your moka pot and which won't. Information number 785, freshness. I'm pretty sure that on all of the bags of coffee beans there is a date. Each of the bags have to have an information of expiry date. That's also good to know, although coffee doesn't really expire in the meaning of you can't really drink it anymore because you die. The particular date that you are looking for, though, is the date of when the coffee was roasted. Beans lose the flavors and the aroma much quicker than what the best before date say. The coffee not necessarily reaches its potential when you actually grab the beans. Some of the coffee needs a little bit of time to breathe, just like wine. By knowing when the coffee was roasted, you will be able to tell if you rather should wait or how the coffee is gonna react when you put it through the grinder. We're also going to talk about freshness of coffee and how that impacts the coffee extraction later on. Information number 7, whether the beans come as a whole or it's already be ground in particular size. Perhaps you don't own a grinder, but you have a plunger and you would like to enjoy a coffee that you brew by yourself first thing in the morning. The roasteries are able to grind that coffee for you. I will say it now though, there is nothing better than providing yourself with the grinder that you can freshly ground your coffee. The difference between freshly ground coffee and pre-ground coffee is huge. We're gonna also talk about it soon. This might be the last one. Information about the notes. You might be aware that all the informations that the roastery provided you with are important. They had some impact on the flavor of the coffee. For sure, they placed it there for some reason, but you don't have to be an expert and you don't have to remember in this particular moment what SL27 means on the back. Coffee tasting is very personal experience. Just because in this particular coffee, I picked some almonds, you don't necessarily have to taste the same thing. The flavor notes are supposed to help you choosing the coffee that you potentially might like the most. This is the data of the flavors that people who roasted the coffee and tasted it later on came to the conclusion after drinking many samples of this coffee that it tastes like roast almonds with a pinch of salt at the aftertaste. Don't stress out too much. It's not that you have to find those flavors in the coffee. It's some guideline that this coffee is my be going very good with the cake that you're making, or you already have a coffee at home that on the label says that it tastes like mandarin. Why mandarin again? That's the only flavor I know. But maybe you just wanted to try something more close to cocoa or peanut butter. I stopped now because, as you can probably already see, simply the more information the better. The more experience you will be having in drinking the coffee, the quicker you'll be able to understand that label quickly. This episode was supposed to tell you the difference between the bags of specialty coffee and the bags of commodity coffee. So why I was focusing mostly on specialty beans, none of the commodity coffee has those informations. Very broadly speaking, specialty coffee industry is about transparency. Specialty coffee producers, roasteries, they are proud of the product. They want to showcase it as widely as possible, every aspect of it, not only to make sure that you will be able to choose the coffee that you would like the most, but also to let you know that there is so much behind the coffee that only by looking at the bag, you'll be like, damn, they know their shit. They are proud of their product. They are proud of people that they work with. They are proud of producers. They want to extend the role of the farmers, and I think that deserve an appreciation. Of course, don't get me wrong, just because all the labels and all the informations on the back are provided, it doesn't automatically mean that the coffee will be great. Like in every other industry, quality of products is better and worse, like with everything. But the differences between specialty coffee are so small comparing to the differences between commodity coffee and specialty coffee as a whole is massive. And I am 100% sure that you won't find any of the coffees with informations on their bags like this in the supermarket. There are groceries that slowly starting to cooperate with the wider audience, so they slowly supply supermarkets. But if you don't really have the knowledge of what is this particular roastery, if I was you, I would contact the roastery directly. The coffee is usually fresher. You will be able also to ask many questions that they will be very willing to answer. I'm pretty sure that they will do their best to help you finding the coffee that you really want to drink. Talk to the barista from your favorite coffee shop. Talk to the friends that you know that is already crazy about the coffee. Talk to me. I will happily answer all of your questions. I will be also very happy if you subscribe my channel or give it a like, so we're gonna reach out to more of the people. This is the first time I'm saying it and it feels so good. You send the message, yo. Cut! You help me reaching more people and we're all gonna drink more coffee and it's all gonna be fun. Until the next episode. Peace and coffee.
Take a sip of coffee. It's a tea.